Welcome to the latest edition of the Wrestle Ropes podcast. I am your host, as always, Billy. I am joined in a historic moment, using that word historic around in this episode, as I am joined by someone I put in the preview when I was on Twitter, who's written literally hundreds of things for our website. He's a fellow Northeast wrestling fan. He is just, I say lead writer because I avoid writing as much as I possibly can unless it's results. It's Adam Morrison.
A hassle welcome sometimes.
Oh, God.
Introduce me to get a drink. That's what to do. Yeah. Welcome. I don't mind saying welcome. Here we are. Yeah, it's good to be here, finally.
Yeah, it's been a long time coming, I think. Especially since we started doing the videos for us. And then you got poached.
Pop culture finally got back to me.
You got poached by the big leagues. And
I've stopped writing for them now, so. But.
Yeah,
that's a different story in itself.
You're everywhere. I think you're inside the ropes. Has Cultaholic picked you up yet? It's just
I never apply, but they don't get back to you. So
yeah, damn them.
Sad
times.
But
so you've been writing for us for God, how long now? Must be.
It was 2016 because I remember it was right at the start of the year, and I was doing those like going through a cage match, and basically this happened, this happened, this happened. Without too much detail. And there, looking back, is just, what was that? Why did you allow me to put that out?
Because you saw my stuff. It was not as, it was just as bad. I'll say just as bad. It was the same kind of quality. I think we've both gotten a little bit better over that time. We now actually
have opinions. About, yeah, that's all it is now, opinions. About returns, debuts. It's never going to happen, but.
I know. I mean,
we're here.
We got at least one right, kind of with Aspen back at Summer Hill. I mean, I think it was fairly obvious, but still,
it was zero that or a surprise return in the Rumble. He was coming back at some point.
Aye, so we got there in the end. But no, so I mean, 6 years you've been doing previews, reviews, spotlights, armchair booking, and everything in between. And now we've finally got you on the podcast. So, usually my questions for interviews would be, how'd you get into wrestling? But, you know, not many people would have, this is your first podcast, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
So how did you actually get into pro wrestling?
So I remember this for some reason perfectly. I was off school one day and it was Survivor Series 2008. My mum was watching a record or something. It was like a storm, so it didn't record the night before. I watched on a Monday. So my first match had the Great Khali in it, which I think sums up my taste in wrestling perfectly. It was like Team Shawn Michaels against Team JBL, I'm pretty sure.
Classic.
Great Khali was there, Crime Time was there. And then just since then, watching everything I can, TNA, Ring of Honor, PWG, New Japan, anything I can get my hands on.
So was that the one with the two triple threats? Was that DX and John Cena and one of them and... Oh, God, who was it? Batista?
I think that might have been the year after. Right. I think this one was like John Cena just come back. And he was against Jericho for the title.
Right, okay.
Because Edge came back, the main event, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, Edge came back.
Because Jeff Hardy was dumped out of it for mysterious reasons. And Vicky Guerrero came out and went, he's here. And then Edge came out and everyone was raging.
And there began my... I won't say obsession, but I'll say fanfare. Is that a word I can use here for Edge? He's like just at the top.
Yeah.
When he came back, that was a feeling.
It was definitely some feels. And I was downstairs watching it and trying to be as quiet as possible, but also as excited as possible at Edge coming out. Like going, I can't shout because I'll wake up everyone in this house. But, oh my God.
I've seen the rumours and all that, and then just when he came out, just think about it than that.
Yeah, I mean, I've had to stop reading them because it spoils the fun of wrestling. Wrestling's supposed to be fun.
Yeah.
I was like, back in my youth, which will age me terribly, but I didn't know who this Brock Lesnar guy was. The only time I'd seen him was in WWF Magazine, I would have been WWF Magazine, and then a month after it was WWE. And I was like, I have no idea who this guy is. And eventually I saw him, I think, maybe possibly Vengeance that year, I think, and 2002. And Yeah, I was like, oh my God, okay, I get it. And nowadays, it'd be like, oh, here's all the matches they've had in PWG, in Evolve, in WXW somewhere, who knows? And now you're like, ah, it's not so much of a shock and surprise. Anyway, for people that are listening to this, this is the Wrestle Ropes podcast. We are going to do a preview of this weekend's WrestleZone Live in Ellon. That's the hope. Storm Dudley is here, apparently.
Get the tables, guys.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's been Twitter the whole day. I'm loving it. And then I spoiled it by having Storm Eunice afterwards. I'm like, I can't make a joke out of that one.
That doesn't really work.
No. But no, so everyone watch your tables, and hopefully we'll be able to see some awesome. Hopefully, I mean, I'm hoping maybe some masked person at this show will go through a table just for the lulls of Storm Dudley. But we'll get onto that in a bit. So WrestleZone, we're both big fans of WrestleZone. That's no secret. That's the thing. At times, it turns out our website is just
big fans, insane fans. You know,
we are
too much into it.
Oh God, yes. We can write essays on one like moment of one turn, one punch, and you're like, oh my God, we've got an essay. It's the meaning of this punch.
Like, I think one of the rumbles when Sean won, just looked Damien gave him. I was like, something's going on there. And then that led on to the whole show next year. So,
yeah, when that main event happened, I was asked to do some stuff for WrestleZone, and I ended up, yeah, I think I wrote about, oh God, about 3 pages worth of backstory. And I'm certain they probably looked at it and went, that lined up quite nicely. And I'm just like, going, it's all done on purpose. I'm like that's Always Sunny meme with Charlie. With the background, with all the tape and the strings and that.
I haven't got a clue. I'll pretend to know.
That's fine. I only know the memes. I've watched like 5 seasons of it. It's not for me. But
it's one of those shows I always mean to get into. Then it's like, there's too much of it.
It's at the point where I watch it and go, and the point is they're all terrible people, but they're all terrible to the point where I'm watching it going, I just hate you all. So I have no horse in this fight. Horse in this fight. That's a terrible mash of phrases, but I've no dog in this fight. I don't like any of these. I'm just thinking to watch it. But yeah, so how did you get into WrestleZone then? What was your first WrestleZone show?
So I remember seeing a poster for the first Ballroom show where Billy Gunn and Hacksaw. I didn't actually go to it because I was in McDuff at the time, which is like bang in the middle between Aberdeen and Elgin. But I went to a show at McDuff in September that year, I'm pretty sure it was. That's where it all began. And then I just slowly got into it more and more. And then, yeah, now here we are. Some 7 years later, almost. I'm getting old.
Didn't you start? It'll be 10 years next year I've been watching WrestleZone. And it's 10 years this year since I went to my first Scottish wrestling show. And that's just made me feel so. I'd hear when we started going to wrestle shows. That was an exciting time. But no, that was weird because you're in McDuff, and for those that don't know the geography of the Northeast, I was in Newport, Sligo, which is about, I don't know, 10 miles away from McDuff, something like that. And the only reason I went is because I had a car, really. So I drove to.
I had a car, I'd be there.
Yeah, I drove to Inverurie because I didn't like driving to Aberdeen. It terrified me, the thought. And then I took a train to Inverurie to Aberdeen. And then next year, I just went, I'll just drive all the way. And I couldn't believe how easy it was. I was like, I've messed up with this plan.
I mean, parking's a different story in itself, but
yeah,
the drive isn't too bad.
The ballrooms were fine because they've got that big one. Well, again, I didn't even know because I don't know Aberdeen, but they've got that big one up at the range and all that kind of stuff. But again, the first year I went, I didn't know where I was. I didn't want to stray too far. I ended up eating at the gym behind the beach ballroom because I was too scared to go anywhere. And I was, what was that, 2013? I was 22. I should have been a bit more brave at 22, but I was from the sticks. I was from Rothes, so I was from the anything with three stories was a big scary world for me. But no,
you got there eventually.
I got there. It's
on the show.
And well, now Kelly drives all the time, so it's even better. I don't even have to drive from Aberdeen.
I'm gonna say I might just pay for petrol and get driven whenever I want. So it's fine.
Yeah, that's always the best way. You can just sit back and regale all the stories and the storylines for your partner. Just go, very good.
So he has a hat when he misses a swanton bomb. Cool.
Oh, yeah. Kelly does not believe the Super Executioner exists because I've told her about him. Mm-hmm. And I've seen pictures. She's seen pictures of him. Never seen him live, so does not believe he actually exists. And
all she has to do is watch that match with William Sterling, the lightsaber battle. I watched that at least 10 times. It's great.
I was front row for it. That was the best day ever. It was so worth going to Fraserburgh, of all places, to go see, because it was like, worth it.
And that's the thing. Some of these smaller shows, you get some great stuff out of it.
Oh, yeah. Of course, you get the classic Super Executioner table camouflage. And on that show, I think it was Aspen Faith versus Scotty Swift. So
yeah. That
was worth finding this really tiny building in Fraserburgh alone just for that. Pain in the arse to find the sat nav. Just saying, WrestleZone. You pick some weird places to have shows.
It's a really tight staircase as well. There's no need for that.
I hate staircases.
Oh, I wonder how they got the ring up there.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good thought. I mean, going to a show, I mean, seeing a show at the Rocks Hotel, went to the Lita meet and greet, and then UPW were doing a show the week after, and I just looked at the venue and thought, how? There's so much glass here. How are you getting anything in here? Because that's a lie. I hope you have liability insurance. That's how boring I am when I was looking at it going, I need some coverage here, I think. That's
fine. You got to see Name Redacted against Name Redacted, so it's fine.
Oh, no, I didn't go to the show. I watched it on YouTube and then hated it. Oh. So
it's a match that looks, at the time, looked good in paper, but
I
heard reviews about some of the stuff they did in the family show. And I'm just like, okay, guys.
No, no, what the scariest thing is, you said that and I thought of a different match. I thought of from the same show and I realized one of them's not Redacted and it was Mastiff. Mastiff and Bram. I was going,
someone probably said something about him. Or he's clean.
Yeah. But the other match. How, why, who, oh God. UPW, though, they're dead. Right. Let's just go into some of this show then. So Ellen, we've been to enough WrestleZone shows now where we kind of know the backstories without having doing too much research. I've just literally got the card in front of me. That's about it. But for anyone listening and they don't know how to go or how to get tickets, you can go to ringsideworld.co.uk. I look for WrestleZone Live in Ellen. Tickets are, I think it's £15 for VIP, get a bonus match, which is going to be one of the greatest bonus matches of all time. I guarantee it, which we'll speak about in a second. But it's taking place this Saturday, the 19th of February, at the Victoria Hall in Ellen. There's buses running if you're in Aberdeen, I'm sure. They usually put up the information about that on their
Facebook. There's a car park. It's great.
Oh, is there? Yeah. Can't wait to find it.
I've been in Google Maps, trust me.
Oh, I did have a wee look. I was really looking to see what was sounding right, like going, right, if I get there with a good hour to spare, where can I go eat? That was kind of my thought process. There's a lot of little cafes in that, so I'm hoping I'll just find a McDonald's, though, because, you know, I've got to save my pennies to buy t-shirts and silly masks. Hoping one day...
I'm going to go to Spider-Man mask on just now.
Unfortunately, it's tidied away because... I don't think I've mentioned it actually on the recording now. For anyone that's listened or read my reviews from the weekend, I mentioned my windows. This is how it's going. There needs to be plasterboard put on, and it's just a thing. And the whole new background, I'm in a different room, so it's a bigger studio, even though now there's just a big window behind me instead. So, you know, when the pod... It's going to be weird, though, because the podcast next 7 that are coming out are in the other room. So this looks like shit. And then the next one that comes out Friday, it's got all my pops in the background, and it's all
nerdy. I didn't get that privilege. I just get the plain white wall.
Unfortunately, you get the window that's just hanging on. And
you got a blurred background, so it's fine. This room's a tip just now, so.
Yeah. I was gonna blur it, but I thought no. I was gonna try and put a an actual background as well, because this is what happens with the podcast. There's no forward planning. I knew it was happening. That's about as far as I got, and I've got the match card in front of me. Anyway, so that's the details of the show itself. Let's just dive in. VIP ticket holder match, last match that was announced. This is why we arranged our chat on Wednesday, because usually wait until 7 p.m. on Wednesday to put the last match out, and then they did it on Tuesday instead, because thanks, guys. It's the Super Executioner making his long-awaited WrestleZone return. He said, from fan demand, I'm fairly certain that might have just been me, but the fan demand made the Super Executioner return, and he's against Scotty Swift in the VIP ticket holder match against Scotty Swift.
We're getting treated. We've got Mickey Vago last time.
Yeah, we've got the Vago in person section last time. And we've got, Scotty Swift, he's just come off quite a run at the moment. He had the title match at Christmas Chaos. He had the big tag match at Halloween Hijinks. And then just this past, last month, he obviously had the big brawl with the outfit, and Omar Mohammed got knocked AF.
He died, basically.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, he's probably he's going to turn up like a Force ghost. I don't know if this is just an old reference. A Force ghost with Mr. Malice somewhere in the future. Just
that's waiting. A team waiting to happen.
Omar and Mr. Malice.
Kameez, is it called? Get him one.
That's it. That's just what we need. So yeah, Super Executioner Scotty Swift. That's just going to be amazing. Your thoughts on it?
Well, I was there for the blindfold match I had a few years ago, and that was an experience. And now just seeing this match, it's always a good time when Scott and Executioner are in the match together, but I'm not too sure what to expect because it's just Super Executioner. You never know what to expect.
Of course. I mean, for anyone that's interested, this is going to be a lot of plugs for my own stuff today. I'm quite excited for this. But no, we did last year we did a watch-along with Scotty. It was supposed to be just a watch-along, a 30-minute thing. Ended up going for an hour and a half. But, you know, that's just what you get.
It's a Scottish Swift style.
Exactly. If you have Scotty Swift on, that's what you're getting as a podcast guest. But we did a watch-along with their match and Keith. And, I'm thinking that Scotty's got some ideas to right some wrongs that he was discussing about that match, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. It's gonna be your VIP match. I think you're paying extra for a reason because it's just gonna be absolute absurd madness.
It's their first like smaller show since coming back, so I think having an executioner out there, like because I'm assuming there's gonna be a lot of kids there, like there always is. Get all the kids involved with executioner shenanigans, and yeah, Scotty Swift's her big character again, so it's a perfect match, really.
My only request is if Super Executioner is about, I need to get a picture with him. Just, again, just to prove that he actually exists and I have not made him up. So if Super Executioner somehow listens to this, please let me get a picture with you. I'll get the selfie out and I'll wear my mask and everything, so there's no germs, even though you're technically super smelly. But you know, we'll figure something out because I need to prove that you're real. And I haven't made you up as a just an imaginary friend, which
that's what's most important here. Proving that he's real.
Exactly. It's like Santa Claus. He only turns up once a year. He's the Undertaker. He's the Undertaker of WrestleZone. He only turns up a couple times a year.
I mean, he already wears all black, so it could be.
Have you ever seen the Undertaker and Super Executioner in the same room?
Exactly.
There you go. There's your
your Aragonic match next year.
Oh, I do the doink spot, just hands up, Undertaker, and I've been. I bought my ticket already. That's happening. So yeah, it's gonna be it's gonna be a lot of fun, a lot of madness, and I think it's just for us as nerds for WrestleZone, that just seems like a really big match for the VIP show. But I suppose they're trying to kind of big up this VIP, I think, because it's what, £3 extra. And
at this point, who is in VIP? Let's be honest.
Yeah, there is that. So we might see the rollout of actual VIP two rows this time because it's a smaller venue, or everyone's going to look at it and go, "Nah, £10 to miss a match, or pay a fiver extra for the kids to see the next one." Happy as well to pay an extra fiver.
Worth it for the execution.
Exactly.
As I say, just go on YouTube, watch that match with Sterling from Fraserburgh, and you're sold.
Yeah, that's it. That's all I need. So I don't know if Scotty's going to have some Ghostbuster shenanigans. I'm too excited for it. So we'll move on to the next one. So we'll just go for a match that you're excited for. We do have a question about it, which I'm just trying to find in front of me now. But it's Sisto against Ronan King. Ronan effing Amaze King. Effing King. Ronan effing King.
You should go with that, though. Amaze King. That should be his new...
Have you seen his tattoo?
I have. That's commitment. I'll say that much.
That is a brave choice for a tattoo. So anyone that doesn't know that he's got his own name tattooed on his body, and like the old Cody Rhodes, over the heart kind of thing. It's like I say, it's a bold choice when it comes to tattoos, and I just hope that he doesn't end up going by a different moniker anytime soon and looking a little bit silly. But no, he has put a question in. He's put, Ronan King has put a question. He says, how dead is Sisto when he comes against the handsome hero of the people that is Ronan King?
How dead is Sisto? That's a question itself.
Inside and out. What are your thoughts on Ronan King?
He's a good wrestler. I think, all this time, like, Summer Hill review, all I have, my problem with him is he gets up to quite after a finish. That's all there is. That's not my only problem with him. And the zebra print tights. Not a fan.
No.
No.
I don't want to throw out any spoilers for my chat that goes out on April 1st with him. But there is a reason why he dresses that way. And because you're part of the writing team, I will send you a link to the chat so you can have a look at it early. But yeah, there's
I'm
a very
I'm going to feel bad now.
No, there's a very good reason why he dresses that way. But it's still worthy of mocking with his zebra print. But yeah, boisterous. But yeah, he's a little bit quick, which is always seems to be the case when WrestleZone guys come in for their first couple matches. They're always a little bit too fast, and they just need to slow way down. And just,
I mean, he's getting there. He's not bad. Mm-hmm. But just the finishing touches need to be made.
Yeah, and I'm sure a couple. And of course, if you stop swearing, that would be good.
Yeah, especially when Ellen, where there's going to be a lot of families.
A lot of families. I'm assuming a very echoey hall as well. So I will actually hear it if he swears this time. Mm-hmm. Even though I still can't believe I was less than like 2 meters away from him. I didn't even notice. Didn't even notice he swore. And
I just think when that happened, not many people knew what to do. It just went silent. It's like time stopped. Mickey Vega didn't have a clue what to hear.
But no, I don't know why we started. I don't know why I've started with the two.
You start with the two main events. Yes, you're done.
But the same with the Super Executioner Scotty Swift match and this one. It's going to be something. I think you described.
Yeah.
The pre-show. I think this is going to be kind of a bigger test for Ronan King than people might not think. Not just because
bigger test against systems.
Yeah. Not so much as an in-ring standpoint, but as a character standpoint, I think it's a bit more. It's like, yeah, you've been in the ring with Mickey Vago. People love Mickey Vago, but he's got a character.
People love Sisto.
People love Sisto, but Sisto.
So I'm told.
But Sisto doesn't speak, so he's gonna have to, and he doesn't have any face. Doesn't have a facial expression either, so it's gonna be a little bit more of a task for Ronan, but. No, Sisto, what's your problem with Tangerine Dream?
It's just not my style.
It's not enough for you to put you off going, but enough for you to go, might have a wee look at the merch stand when Sisto comes out.
I'll buy a Blue Thunder mask, just to rub it in Sisto's face.
Poor Sisto.
Tag Team Champion, Sisto was very
Exactly. Former tag lost Sisto's with Sisto number two. And
for my time, so I'm not going to believe until I see it.
My first experience with Sisto was the first show I ever went to for WrestleZone. So the Beach Ballroom, that Billy Gunn show and Hacksaw. So I'm just...
Billy Gunn, Jim Duggan and Sisto. There's a lineup.
Sisto was thankfully the VIP. He was the VIP match with Malice and Blue Thunder. So he had Thunder in there. Match. So good. It's on the DVD, so it's on the extras.
I think I've got the DVD. I'll watch that later.
It's again something.
Sisto and Mr. Miles, you know. It's always going to be something.
Something.
I don't know what, but.
So yeah, Sisto Ronan King. I jokingly said that for swearing, this is Ronan King's punishment. He has to go in the ring with Sisto, for a bit. So good. Sorry, Ronan. this is what happens if you swear again. You're going to be in the ring with, especially something really mean, Jimbo. They're going to bring Jimbo back. That's what
The thing is, when he was around, I didn't mind him that much. But looking back, I was just happy to be around, to be honest. I was happy to go to shows and like everyone.
Oh, yeah.
Back then, he was fine. But at the start, I mean.
Yeah. He's the only guy I was really mean about for the first time in the WrestleZone show. And I don't think he's ever forgiven me for it, really.
That's why he left. He couldn't handle it.
Possibly. I mean, I have had guys in the past contact me going, do you not like me? Like, not personally. You're not very good. Well, the match wasn't very good, but I don't hate you, if that makes it any better. But
shake your page down. Watch out.
Oh, God. Oh, that would be a low move.
That's a great story.
Oh, it's incredible. That wasn't even me. I put that out. I just put out a video, and it wasn't even me in it. And, screw you. Poundland Braveheart. Poundland Bret Hart. What would be a Poundland Braveheart? Jesus. Beggars. I wouldn't. Couldn't be imagining it now. Don't know who. Anyway. Right. So, yeah. So, Sister Ronan King. We've got next up Evan Young, another young guy coming through the ranks who just made his debut just at the end of last year against William Sterling. We're hoping William's recovered from his knee injury. We're not sure which knee was injured. I don't think William's entirely sure either from the promo video that he did. I think the crowd's going to really get into this one because Evan's just loved.
If his mum's around again, then I was next to her at Chaos and she was just screaming the whole night. She was getting really into, not just for Evan Young's match either. She's well up for it.
Don't clip that bit, anyone. But yeah, so I like that. I like when people come to wrestling shows. I mean, we're both the same, as in we don't sound like we're enjoying what's happening. We don't look like we're enjoying it's happening.
And I mean, well, the exception being the end of Summer Hill, but
even then, I watched the video back. In my head, I was like going mad. My face was going like crazy, and I watched it back going, did I like this? Because my face says no. And
you stood up and clap, that's enough.
That's a big deal. Yeah, if I stand up and clap, if I actually get off of my arse, then that's praise.
I mean, you got pushed back down by looks of it by Zach, but still.
Yeah, I didn't even know he was there. That was the weird thing, because I was so invested in seeing Aspen appear, and then suddenly Zach was in front of me, and I was like, Jesus Christ, hello.
What I liked about that is it came out in his own t-shirt. It was like when Sting took off the Sting mask. It was just Sting.
I know. It's like, but everyone played into it. Everyone still, like, we're like, whoa, who could it be? It's fairly Nacho obvious.
It just wasn't him. It was just someone else.
I know. But no, Pink.
It's
Pink.
Jim Babanen coming back, guys. Here he is.
Oh, Jesus. I think I would have just... I think I might have stormed
the ring. Left and never came back. Yeah, storm the ring. Come on.
I would have been happy being cancelled if it was him. No offence to Jimbo, but, you know.
I'm sure he's a great guy.
But... I'm sure he's very nice. And that, but no, if he came out in his pink trainers, shorts, Aspen Faith t-shirt, and pigtails, it was very clear who it was. But yeah, we all waited just to make sure. Somehow,
that's the beauty of WrestleZone. Stories you have to get invested yourself into, and then you know maybe it won't happen. Maybe it's not him. Maybe it was someone else. But no, it was him this time. Finally coming back.
Maybe you'll keep the towel on and exit without you ever taking it off. We won't know who it was. We'll just be like, was it?
Nice towel.
Was it him? But no, it's, yeah, it was great.
I don't know how we got onto this, by the way. We're speaking about Evan Young.
I know. It went Evan Young's mum, Summerhill, and we've ended up with Aspen. Yeah. But no, I was going to say, yeah, it's great seeing fans get so invested in shows like Evan's mum, who I've only heard the legend of her through K&K Wrestle Factory, and now yourself adding to it, just getting so into the wrestling, and it makes up for us mentally trying to remember what's happening and just enjoying what we're seeing without actually showing that we enjoy it. When we got all the people around about us just going absolutely mental and or in Kelly's case, screaming my name, which, you know, I didn't think that
That's
would
all
be
I
on
heard
camera.
When he came out.
I didn't think that would be on camera.
I didn't think the camera would pick up. I could hear it from the other side of the room.
I didn't think that would pick up either. And I was like, oh my God, all the years, like, lights go out. Billy! Oh, okay. I thought that was that wasn't as loud in my head when that happened. But anyway, we'll go back to the match. Evan Young, William Starling. So this kind of kicked off round about Christmas chaos because that they were in the six-man tag opposite sides. Evan kind of got the best of William Starling. And then this kind of got picked up again now in Ellon after was it Evan was against Ronan at Christmas Chaos, and then he wasn't on the Summerhill show, but William was in the match with the tag champions Connor and Crusher and team of Caleb, but got injured. For anyone looking for the backstory, there you go. That's all of it. And now they're facing off again. So this is going to be your big man, little man, classic, Mysterio, Big Show, Mysterio, Kali. Trying to get anyone else.
Other people as well.
Yeah.
Hornswoggle is someone. Hornswoggle and looking sharp. There you go.
There you go. I mean, that's a gargantuan match itself. But so I think this is going to be a lot of shenanigans of William being a bit of a bloody bully. Hopefully, if his knee's okay.
Yes, but, spring for the knee.
So yeah, your thoughts on Evan, seeing Evan for the first time, and your thoughts on this match in general.
When he came out at Halloween, you could tell there was something there because he was like already getting the crown of Vesta when he came out. And then when he just got in, he was looked like he'd been in it for a few months, not just his first night. He was, you know, like drop kicks and bulldogs and all sorts. So I wasn't expecting that. I was expecting just, you know, the basic arm drags, maybe a few rolls here and there, all that stuff. But you know, he was really good. And at Christmas Kiss again, good match with Ronan King. I'm pretty sure Kyle and Kayla said this, but having two new guys against each other is like, you don't know what to expect, but it was fine for what it was. And then, you know, having him against William now on his own, that's going to be his first big test, in my opinion.
The thing, when we saw Evan for the first time, yeah, you say he looked at the part already, because often, like we've said, we kind of rode in a little bit, and some others, when they have their first couple of matches, they kind of, they hunch, they don't kind of present themselves to the, that's me hitting the mic, present themselves to the crowd, and he was up for it. He was up to get involved, and I don't know if it's just because he had Scotty and Mr. P with him, and it's very easy to be getting hyped when you've got those two next to you. But no, he definitely came in like a star, and he came out looking even better, and he got a standing ovation, I think, as well at the end of that match. And hopefully this continues it. But yeah, it's going to be, I don't want to say something again for a third match in the row, but it's going to be emotional, this one, I think, with getting Evan trying to make it and topple Big William. I mean, I thought William was kind of, because I think he missed Chaos, didn't he? So I thought that was William Starling kind of just, he was quietly just stepping away. But
yeah, there's something going on. I wasn't too sure what was going to happen with him, but he seems to be teaming with Ellon again. I don't know.
I think Alan's might need all the help he can get.
Get now is those two doing Dances with Caleb. I'm up for that.
Yeah, but if our armchair booking is to be believed, then I think Alan's going to need some help, and William's probably. It's you know, what's blood's thicker than water, and you know Alan's around water all the time because he's a captain of the ship. I just realised he's not on the show.
He's not. I hope he comes out at some point, just for sake of it.
Give
raffle.
Oh, that'd be amazing. Give Caleb some emotional support against Crusher, maybe. Fingers crossed. But no, we'll get into the tag team champions we kind of half mentioned in that point. Brian Tucker against Connor Malloy is the next match we've got here. Brian has not had a great run since the return of shows in our...
Maybe he has, and we're just overshadowing that by not liking him that much just now.
Maybe. I mean, everyone's like going on about his attire, and it is very basic, Rollers-esque. But I like it. As a wrestling attire, maybe not so much. But no,
I think you might be alone in liking it.
I think it's many people too. I've got a pair of tartan trousers myself, but they're grey. I mean, but I'm looking at the red going, I think I may be able to. I think if I put them on, I just look like, no, I don't know what I'd look like. Bagpipes, probably. Just look like bagpipes wearing that. But he hasn't had the best of luck. I think his match with Alex Webb was okay. Alex was really good, and I liked that Brian brought a little bit of charisma with the old vlog.
The first one.
And I can't wait for it. I need all the fashion tips I can get.
If he's going to do it, I hope he actually does put out vlogs. That would be amazing.
I don't know where he'd upload them, because I don't think MySpace still exists. But I'm sure he'll find
him on Dailymotion. I don't know.
Dailymotion. Yeah, we can finally get some Brian Tucker's tips. There you go. There's your title for your first one, Brian. But he's going against Connor Malloy. Connor, a rare singles outing. He's been more in the tag team division recently with Crusher. A little bit of not an odd matchup, but it's not a match you'd expect to see anytime soon, just because of where they are respectively. One in the tag team division, and Brian kind of there. So I think it's going to be a bit of an interesting clash. Do you think?
Yeah, I was surprised when this went out. I was like, it's interesting, as you say, but it all depends how the match actually goes. As we say, Brian's not had the best runs because of the whole Sean Johnson feud not being great, we'll say. And then, but going against Connor, he's really coming to his own since Joe's came back, I would say. He's doing the whole Eddie Guerrero stuff. And then he's, as I say, really coming to his own. He's really become a star on his own and as a tag team, the Crusher. But going against Brian, who's done it all, he's been there before, that could be a big test for him. He's had to test the Crusher before, obviously. But going against Brian there, this could really do something for him, I think.
Especially, like we're saying, he's been in the tag team. He's been doing a tag team thing since, well, before the pandemic. He was starting team with Crusher a little bit. So he hasn't had a on-show singles match for 2 years-ish. Something like that. Oh, it must be by now, about 2 years. So that's going to be a bit different. He's got nobody to kind of tag out and refresh himself. And we were both determined he was going to get absolutely demolished by Crusher by accident at the last show as well, which we were wrong, because of course we were. So I don't know if this is kind of testing the waters for him in a singles role. And we'll see what happens with Connor and Crusher in the future. But again, we're just terrible predictions, but I'm predicting, I think, at the end of this year, we're not going to have Connor and Crusher as a team.
Just trying to think what could happen with Crusher after this. Just go back to just being a big beast or what?
Or taking another big guy under his wing and just being two big forces.
And just get him a Mauler. Mauler, I don't see much going on for him just now.
Yeah, Mauler needs a pal. Mauler and Crusher seems to be the most logical way forward that I could see as well.
As he changes his trousers, that's all.
Again, in our chat we've got coming up on the podcast feed, but I do have a chat with Mauler coming up, and we do discuss his attire choices.
I'm going to feel bad.
No, don't feel bad about that. By the sounds of it, with my podcast chats, I just speak about attires and dinosaurs. I mean, that's not entirely inaccurate, but there is more to it for anyone listening who wants to go back through the archives. You can find good chats with, like, Aspen Faith and most of the guys on this roster, just about all of them. I haven't got Sisto yet. I'm hoping to get a Sisto.
That's what I'm waiting to have. We've got all three Sistos on. I'm still waiting for the Lord's Roundtable to come out.
Trying to get a hold of, I mean, I've got to get a Ouija board out if I want to get Malice. And then, it's difficult to get contact on a ship.
Get four people on and just have Lord Michael sitting in the corner saying, "I am majestic," every now and again. That's all you need.
Maybe the 2 year special or the anniversary show. I'll do my best. I'll do my damnedest to try and get at least one of the lords on. If I can get two or three, even better. And then get Sisto as well. Why not? Make it fun. Just have him there as well.
What's in our lineup, honestly?
So yeah,
it's gonna be a podcast after that.
Yeah, I mean, that'll be it. To 150 episodes, that's it. It's worth it. Just shut it down now.
What a waste of
time. But no, Brian Connor, it's going to be intriguing. I think that's a good way to describe it. It's intriguing. So you don't know. There's so many variables in the story coming into this, because Connor's, again, has not been a tag wrestler. Brian has not had the luckiest of goes about it. It's going to be interesting.
It'll be a good match. That's all we need.
Oh yeah, I mean, for all we say about Brian of his run, it's more his shenanigans and character than his actual wrestling. His wrestling is still very good. He's still
a good wrestler, just everything else.
Yeah, it's just
I feel bad. I've come on the podcast slighting everyone.
That's all right. We'll get in a bit. We've got three matches to talk about. I'm sure we'll shoot on someone else by the time that we get to the end of it.
Come on for that shooter of the year award in the match.
I think you're gonna have to wait for it for a while. I don't think I've actually got any of that bad ones coming up, but I know in the past Johnny Lyons episode, anyone listening, Johnny Lyons episode, I'd be as well just hand on the gun. It was just I didn't even try to stop him. I was just like, nah, on you.
I like to think happy, just sent in the link to join the Zoom. He just sat there and listened.
Yeah, I could have done, and only kind of interrupted because I knew I was like. We're both old at this point, so I knew 10 o'clock is my bedtime, so I was like, I'm going to have to get some questions in here before we kind of both go to bed separately. So we won't go for the big main event, well, big lads fighting, we'll leave that one to the end. We'll go for Damien and Dino.
Next. This is one I'm really excited for.
So Dino Del Monte, of course, he just made his in-ring return last month by knocking the F out of Omar Muhammad. I'm hearing rumors that Ted might not be be in this match or be at the show at all. So he could be on his own. So I think this is going to be Dino's breakout match, if there's going to be one.
He's really come a long way. I know I said this a lot, but he's really come a long way since he debuted. Because remember when he debuted, had all these facial expressions just over the top. And I was just a big bruiser. He's like a real one of the big lads, like Crusher and Caleb. He could really go far after this match.
Of course, that was the debut when he had like just one shirt sleeve all the way down and one cut off.
Yeah.
What a look. That was a look. But no, yeah.
Tyrus, once again, we're speaking about them.
I know. It should come to us. Come to us and we'll tell you if it's a good look or not. And we'll just, even though, you know, fashionista here, I'm in my job.
Where am I? Can I go top?
I know, and I'm going for Damien this time. Can't see it. But yeah, Damien versus the world that Kyle absolutely disgracefully told Kaylee she could not buy. And that's, you know, that's just what happens when you just bought one, Kaylee. You just bought one. That's taking money. That's taking food away from Damien and his amazingly cute daughter.
And she gets invested.
Exactly. So Damien, non-title match, so we don't have the theories in that he's going to lose the title this time, so I'm sure he's glad of that. Coming off a very incredible match with Zach Dynamite, a slow burn match that went all over the venue, and even that apron suplex thing, that still kind of haunts me a little bit. It's not kind of removed the Caleb thing, but you know, it's up there now.
I thought he was going for a DDT at first. I was like, you can't be doing that. Come on.
I was like, oh, no, we're going to make it worse.
Right on the edge as well. Yeah. It was on like part of the apron, fine, but on the edge. Come on.
Hardest part of the ring. So the rumor is.
Trademark.
So Damien is not title match. He's got a kind of upcoming, he's got some suitors that are coming after the title at the moment. Of course, Zach Dynamite and the Foundation of the Future are still kind of going to be champing for that belt. And of course, as we've mentioned, Aspen is coming back. He's come to the Regal Rumble, and that seems like it's going to be... I mean, we're going to put in early predictions here, but we're thinking it's going to be Damien and Aspen, maybe Damien, Aspen, and Zach main event for Anarchy. And
I've been thinking about this. Because of the way the Zach match ended with a low blow, I don't think it's over. So I'm thinking maybe double end, double winner even. It's a triple threat.
Do you think Dino might come out with some golden flourishes to his gear and the foundation might be extended?
Honestly, get him in.
Just take him over. Why not? Just put Connor. I think Connor needs some gold in his gear as well. I think, like we're saying, this is going to be Dino's breakout match. He's got the old George Michael look. He's got the mullet, which, you know, bold choice.
Yeah. For once, so I'm not slating the tire. It's a good choice.
Hopefully he keeps his belt on this time. That would be nice, because that was an eyeful that I didn't need for Saturday night. This is, there's not much more we can really say about it, because Damien's still having bangers matches, even though we're predicting he's losing the belt every time he puts it on the line, but he's still putting in excellent emotional matches as well. I'm fully invested in Damien, even though I'm sitting there going, well, you're losing the belt in 20 minutes, so, you know, good luck. This is going to be a bit of a, I think it's going to be a war, because they're both quite, they've got big forearms as they're in their arsenal. It's going to be, could be a lot of fun. So let's get into the big six man then. I know the promo went out about an hour before we started recording with Mr. P and the Rejected, which I haven't watched yet. So I'm assuming Mr. P has found some denim, some cutoffs to throw in, but I don't know.
I'm hoping he comes out full Disciples of Apocalypse.
Maybe not 8-Ball or what was the other one? Not Crush. 8-Ball. Skulls. I love it. I hadn't even thought of that until you suggested that. Yes, I'm all in. Or very least, if he gets into the biker gear and a biker spirit of things, even though they're not bikers, and he comes out and just like a trike, a retricycle or something, and
that's what we need.
Like, was it late 2000s Camacho and Hunico? They came out with the bicycles. Even though I think more of a Mexican thing, but still, you know, it could work. Maybe not so much the John Deere lawnmowers, but, you know, there could be something there.
We won't go there.
No, I didn't realize how bad that was until like I got older. I thought, oh,
I looked for a few weeks ago. I didn't realize.
that's not even close to the knuckle. That is through the knuckle. And, high-fiving the other hand. That's how bad it was. Foundation of the Future, Zach Dynamite, Bruiser Brad Evans, and Ryan Riley taking on Mr. P, the Rejected, Mickey Vago, of course, podcaster extraordinaire, and Chris Archer. This is going to be an absolute brawl.
If it gets out of control, then it could be amazing. It could be... I remember like the Rejected and the Foundation had a little thing going on 2019 with Kane and Garrick. It was just like all at wars like every month, and it was great. If they can just try and get a little bit of that back. Because Rejected is just sort of there now. You've got a good match, but it's just there now. They need something going to get them back in the picture. This could be it.
I mean, there's a fair few tag teams now hanging about WrestleZone. Yeah. Certainly, of course, with the Foundation, the Rejected, and you've got Connor and Crusher being the champions. We had, or we still have, kind of, Alan and Caleb. So, and we may have the Rejected, who knows. The outfit. There's a good few teams coming about. But yeah, I think they kind of all been concentrating on the Undisputed title. I think they kind of splinter off a little bit and concentrate on these other titles that are hanging about as well, and certainly going to, and they're getting about a bit in the country as well, through Fair City, no doubt there'll be Pro 2 at some time this year as well, just from off the top of my head. So there'll be plenty of places they'll see these guys and put a belt on them, just put belts on them. They're amazing, exactly. It's going to be an absolute brawl, wild, all over the place, all over the venue. Hopefully the sandwich boards are taped up and nobody gets knocked out at the end of it. That's probably all the hope we can have for it.
That was amazing. I was like, that was right in my face when they were brawling at Summer Hill. And all aside from Dino's trousers falling down, basically. I just wasn't expected.
I mean, we could really see so much of it where we were the other side, and all you'd hear every so often is some big clatter and go, oh God, what was that? And trying to peer over folk and see what's happening. And you see like a broken bit of plastic. You think, oh God, or was it Omar lifted up just a leg of the sandwich board at one point, and you're looking at it going, Jesus, what's happened? this has gone a little bit out of control here.
It's like that Dino took a floor bump for a show back.
He did promise.
He promised a tree, I'm pretty sure, but only got one.
We might get a couple more before the end of Saturday, I'm sure, because Damien seems to be throwing in these floor bumps willy-nilly, so who knows at this point.
He knows he's on the end of his reign. He's going out of my bank.
We're saying this. He's going to retain it at Anarchy, and he's going to have another year as a champion.
Because we're going to be sitting there in the crowd. Come on, ask me. He's obviously winning that, isn't he? And Damien just wins. I wouldn't be annoyed because Damien, I still like him, but it's not happening.
That's it. Yeah, I think that's going to be. If Damien takes out anything from this preview, that'll be the quote. I like Damien, but he's not Aspen.
Yeah.
But that's it. That's the bit. That's the tweet he'll tag you in afterwards for the whole thing. But no, yeah, Damien's great. It's just, yeah, at this point, we just really want Aspen to be the champion in this preview that he's not on, the show that he's not involved in at all. And here we are.
Yeah, Mr. P.
Mr. P. Rejected. I love Mr. P. I think he's just ace. I think he's just...
It took me a while to get on board Mr. P. train. But now I'm fully on board, got my ticket, and it's amazing. The whole Scotland gimmick wasn't too sure at first. Like, what's the point in this? But now he's really going on with it, and it's great.
It's a bit on the nose. It's a bit thick of character. It's because, like, he's Scottish, so Scotland. But he commits. He's committed to it, and he's just from when you interact with him outside of the actual wrestling matches, he's just nice. And I think that just makes all the difference. Like, there's no bad bone in Mr. P's body, but he'll batter you with a Thez press and a scissor kick, no bother. Or end up just smacking his own head for a bit. But he's just excellent. And I really enjoyed it. It took me a long time to get on board with the Rejected. It took me so long. I didn't, even people cheering them, I was still going, yeah, it's Rejected, But more recently, I actually think Vago's podcast has really helped me get on board with Rejected more, because Vago is just a bit... Archer, I think we already know, he's a bit of a madman in general.
I'd say in the least.
And it still shocks me that he's like 26, and it disgusts me at the same time.
It's not fair. It really is not fair.
And the fact that, he was wrestling when I first started going to shows, and I was 22, and 22. And the fact that he was wrestling then, and he's still going now, and his knees are about 60, but
that's besides the point.
And his back's clearly knackered, but
as long as he can do a moonsault, that's fine.
Yeah, it took a long time to get involved in, not so much the podcast, but I was like on the cusp of getting the Rejected, and then after speaking to Vago, I was like, all right, I kind of get it. It's just two guys waiting. Like when they're more head gear and they're cool gear and just wanting to have a good fight. So I'm like, what's not to love about that, really?
Yeah.
Any particular favorite Vago podcast? Well, while we're speaking about Emily Rain, any particular highlights from the mosh pit so far?
I mean, Mark Jones is up there. Basically, I'm not going to lie. At this point, I'm watching to see what they say about SWE. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
So I didn't know anything went on there. I just know they're not to be watched or attended.
Oh, attended, definitely not. There's moments. I mean, my one wasn't that bad in comparison to other people's stories. It's definitely.
You just went straight in. You didn't waste any time.
I had three beers. I was anyone's at that point. You could have asked for any opinion, and I would have just went straight for it because I don't drink. So three beers, that was it. I was just gonna go shoot in. And even worse, the Moshies Awards, I had seven. So I was just, I was kind of in the corner, just kind of pissed and not really getting asked any questions, because I would have just absolutely rambled and called someone something that would have had to be edited out afterwards. But no, there's a reason why we don't cover them. I think we'll just go for that. We'll just say that. That's the reason why we don't cover them anymore. Because they're just bad people. Anyway, that was, I think, okay, covered the match. So the vehicle, the mosh pit, really, watch it for SWE gossip. That's kind of that's where we are now.
Yeah. Excellent. That's all we need.
So hopefully it comes back, because I think the kind of plan was like the moshes was a little bit of a finale and just see where the lay of the land is. But I hope we get more backstage stuff.
Yeah.
So I want to see more backstage of like these smaller shows, I suppose, like Ellen and that. And if Vago gets Super Executioner on the next episode.
This is how we get System on.
There you go. So Vago, if you've got your camera with you on Saturday, Sisto content. That's what we need. We need all the Sisto content we get.
That'll get the views.
It's certainly two. For me, you're watching. So the first match that was announced for the show was made at Summer Hill Showdown. Mm-hmm. It was Crusher Crabe versus Caleb Valhalla. And I'll be perfectly honest, I'd already kind of thought I'm going to the show as soon as that match was announced or challenged for or teased. Because this is a match I've wanted to see for a long time. But yeah, thoughts on this one?
One of the same. When it was first announced, I was like, I have to go then. I don't usually go to these smaller shows now, but I have to go see Crusher and Caleb. Mm-hmm. So when the poster, I was just like, you know that face you made when you really want something? I was like, you see this? You want to go to it? And he's like, yeah, come on, let's go. So we bought tickets. And it's just going to be, I'm pretty sure Rhys Dawkins said this in commentary, I could hear the commentary being recorded. It's just got to be a big, beefy man slapping meat.
Yeah, I think that's what we're going to get. I mean, we've got kind of a preview of it at Summer Hill Showdown when Connor was kind of left out in the cold.
I felt bad. He was just there. He was just there.
I was kind of shocked about. I was kind of expecting. I did shout at one point and nobody heard it, but I was just asking if Connor needed some orange slices, because he was just getting demolished as soon as he got into the ring. And then, like I say, we thought he was going to get kicked, his head kicked off at the end by Crusher, but didn't end up happening. But this is just going to be, two big guys just throwing and throwing each other. And Caleb really hasn't been in the ring with too many big guys. I think he's been with Asylum at Fair City. That's about it, really. Mm-hmm. Trying to think of any. I mean, no, can't think of any other.
Do we count Lord Mr. Miles?
I mean, he is larger than life. That is true.
Yeah,
and he lifts him with ease, and he seemed to be lifting. Caleb seemed to be lifting Crusher as well, and the fact that in a storyline perspective, Caleb's now going to have preparation. He knows he's only going in the ring with Crusher. Yeah. He's not expecting to be in a tag team match with this, so he's going to be a bit more prepared. He's going to call to all fathers and be able to muster the strength and it's just this match sold the ticket for me. And then the fact that the VIP ticket holder match was Executioner versus Swift, I was like, I've made the right call. I am definitely going to this show. I think that's I suppose this is really the fourth show back. Since the pandemic, I think to at least get some folk in, they're going to have to kind of put some of these dream matches on the smaller shows, even if it's just dream matches again to nerds like us. But at least it will shift tickets to seeing, they're two big dudes. Mm. This is a Haystacks, Big Daddy. It'll be remarkably better than that. But as far as when you're watching the these two guys interact, you're going, this is what it is. It's Haystacks and Big Daddy. I can't wait for this. It's just going to be amazing, hopefully.
And that's like what's good about this card. You can't tell what's going to go on last, because it could be that, it could be Damien and Dino, it could be the 6-man tag. Mm-hmm. It won't be Sisto, but
they could reshuffle the whole lot, and it could be Super Executioner Scotty Swift at the end.
Exactly.
Might put Sisto in the VIP ticket holder match. Why not?
What's the price of admission?
Exactly. But that's the thing. When you look at this card, I mean, we've been to enough shows now to kind of get a feel what some of these matches are going to be like. And you look at it and go, this could be the comedy match. This could be a comedy match, but that could actually be quite a serious match. This could be a wrestler match. This could be the Valhalla Crave is going to be the big dudes slamming each other match. But There's so much variety on this card, which is always why I'm banging on about this company so much, because there's just variety.
Well, going back to Caleb and Prussia, that could be a comedy match in a way if Alan gets involved.
Exactly. And if Alan turns up, I mean, he's no stranger to popping up on the wee TV screen and getting into shenanigans. I mean, if there's a storm going, I don't think he'll be going off port.
Yeah.
So he should be on land. We would like to think.
If he's able to be on land, he wasn't too sure at Summer Hill.
Yeah.
Felt a bit dizzy.
I love Alan Starling. He's just...
He is larger than life too, like Malice.
I'm fairly certain if he wanted to, he could be everywhere. He could just be the best. Right? I mean, he's like, I suppose for anyone listening, like Discovery Wrestling, he's like your Gene Money.
Yeah, I was just about to say that.
Yeah, he's excellent in the ring, but he's so funny at the same time. So give me, if anyone from Discovery is listening, Alan Starling versus Gene Money, please and thanks.
That is the second zombie lumberjack match.
Oh, there we go.
That'd be amazing.
There we go. None of this will happen. None of our predictions will happen, because that's the reputation that we have now. But there's some free ideas for you. We've discussed attire, merch, matches.
Yeah.
We've got it all here. If you want to come for ideas,
SWN's
got your answers. Tattoos. We've got all.
We won't speak of the matches, but that's not the point.
I know. It's going to be very weird that I'm going to be staring at Ronan King's chest for a good portion of his match with Sisto, because I'll be looking at a tattoo going,
why?
Why? But no, it's yeah, he's all in, but I swear if he has to change his gimmick, then he's screwed.
I really hope he does.
Well, I hope in like middle of the year he becomes the next Lord. Or the King. It's going to be Lord Ronan King. How's that for a...
Another free idea for you.
There you go. If you keep swearing at shows, you might be.
<No. laughs> Hope that becomes his new thing. Go for it in somehow.
But no, I'm hoping, again, we've chatted, I'm giving you spoilers for future episodes, but I'm hoping he gets an ECFNW shirt and just get Ronan F and King. That's merch money. Ready. I'm ready to pay for it. But I mean, I've come up with the idea, so if you can
get somewhere to design it, because Aspen's back.
I know, Bear Hug Design, even better. They can get in all the designs. That's the full rundown of the card. It's like I say, there's so much variety. I don't know how we can pick out a match of the night, but is there any in particular that you've kind of got a feeling that this is the match you're gonna be speaking about as soon as the bet ends?
Obviously, he's got Crusher and Caleb, but for me, Damian Dean, that could be something really good.
Yeah. The more that I would have, obviously, Executioner Swift notwithstanding.
Well,
I'm in the same boat. I thought Caleb Valhalla and Crusher Craig was the match I was looking forward to, but now the more we've spoken about it, Damian Dean is going to be, it's going to be something special. I think that's going to be the jumping off point. I'm still not sure in the name Dino Del Monte. I don't know if that needs to kind of be tweaked for me to be fully on board with him up challenging properly with Damien for that title, or even the Tri-Counties maybe. But he's definitely got something. He's got a quality about him that'll certainly be providing plenty of good matches in the future. So for again, everyone listening to this, if you've somehow got through this hour of us talking about WrestleZone, which you should have, because it's absolutely effing amazing.
Yeah.
Doors open 6 p.m. VIP. Most people will probably be VIP. 6:30 for general. Am I right in thinking that? Did I read that in your review that there was like one guy who paid for a general admission ticket that had to wait?
I'd have not got one.
I'm just imagining that. That first match happened at Summer Hill, and then they went, right, okay, the match is over, and you get it. And they're just him only person there. And anyway, yeah, so yeah, 6:30 general bell time, general admission, bell time 7 p.m. Tickets are available at ringsideworld.co.uk. And you can, it's a £10, like £10 for children, £12 for adult general, and it's £15 for VIP. get a VIP ticket, because VIP ticket match is going to be amazing. It's going to set you up for the whole night. It's just going to be the most fun. We're hoping, of course, because the storm is coming, as we've discussed, that the show will actually still take place. And I'm not going to end up being turned around somewhere near Huntley, hoping that my car will make it all the way to the venue itself. But no, it's going to be it's going to be an excellent match, excellent show. It's going to be it's got a nice card to keep you occupied on a Saturday night.
Yeah. For one of the smaller shows, I've really gone all out.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I don't know how many of the smaller shows are going to do this year. I think, I think Inverurie, maybe.
Yeah.
That'll probably be about as far, maybe Montrose.
They have to do Montrose at this point.
Oh, yeah. We're going to get main event, Vago, Valhalla. That's such a main event there. And I mean, selfishly, I'm hoping Keith, because that means I'm only 2 minutes away. And they usually put on an absolute, like they shouldn't be putting on the kind of cards they put on in Keith, because they're usually putting an amazing Damien match somewhere in there, and obviously we get Super Executioner, which is always worth it. But no, that's an hour of people's time that we've kind of talked about this show. I've got much to add. Is there anything you want to add in there as well?
Not really. I'm just going to say I'm pissed off at WrestleZone for booking the Rumble on my sister's wedding day.
Ah, that sucks. You'll be cancelled.
Of course, Aspen's going to win, and I won't be there. So,
I had to call in all the favors to get to, because I was at my mother-in-law's 60th birthday in Aberdeen, and it's like a spa weekend, and I was like, "Can we get away for an evening?" And thankfully, thank God,
you've got birches each year. It's fine.
Yeah, thank God I've pulled in all the favors, and I've but if he doesn't win, I'm going to.
If it doesn't win, it's fine.
I'm going to be furious that I've got, because Aberdeen Anarchy, something will happen that weekend. Even though I've got a ticket, I won't be able to go to that, and that'll be when he wins the title. Anyway, this has been the Aspen Fate. I mean, this has been the WrestleZone live in Ellen preview show for the Wrestle Ropes podcast. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining me, Adam. I'm so glad to actually properly hear your voice for the first time in six years we've interacted.
Six long years.
And for anyone who wants to find out more, you don't just write for SWN, you write for every major publication in the UK.
Too much time on my hands.
It's a good time. Where can people find out more about you?
Mostly just on Twitter, at Adam Morrison 40, for some reason. I don't know why.
Fair enough. So this has been the Wrestle Ropes podcast. You can follow us more. I don't usually plug my own stuff, but I'll do it anyway. At Scott Resnet, Twitter, Instagram, everywhere, swnscotland.com. Join us on Patreon, pay me some money so I can keep doing this and make it worthwhile. But anyway, have a good time. I'll hopefully see you live in Ellen on Saturday. I will look annoyed, but I'll be really happy to be there. Trust me.
See you.